What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Taylor. Welcome, bienvenue. If you're a returning subscriber, great to see you again. Hope you're doing well. I just thought I would do a little quick intro to this soon-to-be video that you will see shortly. But basically, it is August in Paris, and I decided that I was bored AF. So, I decided to do this thing that I did last year, which is called WWOOFing, which stands for Worldwide Organization of Organic Farms. And basically, it's this like volunteering cultural exchange program in which volunteers can get in contact with farmers. And basically, you go live on the farm for like anywhere from a few days to a few weeks. And they teach you about like whether it's permaculture or sustainable living or whatever kind of farm they have. They teach you about that stuff. You help them out for maybe anywhere from 3 to 5 hours a day. And then the rest of the time you just have to explore, hike, like talk with them, talk with the other woofers. Yeah, basically that. I did it last year in Norway, which I did make a video of. So if you're interested in how that went, you can check that out. But this year with all of the travel restrictions and things, I was meant to be going home in September for my best friend's wedding and some other things, but of course, Miss Rona really thrown a wrench into all of our plans. R.I.P. Anyway, so I decided to check into WWOOFing in France, because that way I can stay closer to home, stay in the vicinity should anything go wrong or whatnot. So I found this farm that's in Val d'Arly. It's kind of like between, you have like Geneva, Chamonix, Grenoble, Annecy, Chambéry, I think. I don't know, there's like a few different cities or towns that are in there. And this place is up dans les montagnes, in the mountains. It's like a chalet that is run by this woman who I guess makes a bunch of sort of sustainable biological products. So yeah, I thought what better way to spend the end of August then piecing out the mountains. So that is what I will do. I'm headed there tomorrow. Right now it's about 5:15 p.m. My hair has never looked better. and I just had to get a couple things at the store. I have to do some laundry, pack, which of course is a necessary evil. So yes, I will take you guys along, make a little highlight reel. If you have any questions about WWOOFing or you're interested in WWOOFing, feel free to ask. This will be my second time and I'm sure I'll do it many more times. Honestly, last year it was such a good experience and I'm hoping to have a good experience again. So let's freaking go. Chose qu'on peut entendre ici, c'est les cloches des vaches. Bon bah, salut tout le monde. Ça fait presque une semaine maintenant que je suis à Notre Dame de Bellcombe. C'est un village juste côté des Alpes. C'est en Savoie, en France. Et bah, quand même, ça fait 5 jours que je parle que français, donc c'est pour ça que je parle en français maintenant. Mais bon. Tout se passe très bien là, tu vois que j'ai fait une petite footing. Et en fait, à la base, Notre Dame de Bellcombe, c'est un petit village, c'est une station de ski. Donc en fait, il y a des, c'est quoi le mot, téléski, chairlifts, je sais pas comment on dit ça. Mais bon, je pense que j'ai monté presque au sommet. Là, je suis en forêt. Je pense que l'altitude, c'est vers 1200 mètres. Ah oui, voilà. J'ai vu le sommet. Oui, c'est plutôt sympa d'être toute seule dans les montagnes. Oui, le woofing, ça tout se passe bien là. C'est, on organise des choses. L'hôte de woofing, Aspa Dominique, elle est hyper sympa, hyper gentille et tout. Et en fait, elle connaît beaucoup de choses sur des plantes sauvages en France et en Europe. En général, donc elle nous apprend des choses, c'est chouette, non? Et ouais, donc là, c'est la première fois que j'ai couru depuis mon arrivée. Donc je suis un peu fatiguée, franchement. Ça fait que, quoi, je sais pas, que 20 minutes que je cours et là, je suis au sommet, mais je suis hyper fatiguée, mais vraiment hyper fatiguée. Et j'espère que la descente, ça va se passer mieux, mais je sais pas trop parce que je sais que je vais avoir mal au genou, mais bon, on verra.